Medium, please. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Dear brothers and sisters, Sasri Akal, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you. It is a great pleasure for me to be here today on such a special occasion and speak about the holy personage of Guru Baba Nanak Devji Maharaj, Rahmatullah Alayh, who is not only regarded in the Sikh faith as a guru and holy master, but even amongst Muslims he is regarded as a holy saint. And that is why whenever I refer to his name, I will say a prayer after it, Rahmatullah Alayh, meaning may the mercy of Allah be upon him. I am truly grateful for this kind invitation and would like to thank your community for this opportunity. As the followers and devout believers in the Guru Nanak Devji Maharaj, Rahmatullah Alayh, I can say with certainty that you know far more about his life than me. It might even somewhat seems strange that a Muslim Imam has been asked to speak about Guru Baba Nanak, Rahmatullah Alayh. However, when we look at the history, we find that not only did Muslims have the privilege and honor of enjoying the blessed company of this holy saint, Guru Baba Nanak Devji, Rahmatullah Alayh, also showed great love and respect for the religion of Islam and held beliefs which are also common to Islam. Bhai Mardana is a well-known name amongst the companions of Baba Guru Nanak Ji, Rahmatullah Alayh, and who was not just a companion of Guru Baba Nanak Dev Ji, but a close friend. One of the main beliefs held by Guru Baba Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj, Rahmatullah Alayh, was the unity of God, a belief which is integral to Islam. It is part of the Kalima, the declaration of faith, and the first pillar of Islam. He was born in a Hindu family, but was always impressed with the concept of the oneness of God. The final and well-known teaching of the Guru was Naam Japna, Kirt Karna, and Vanchagna. Again, these are concepts which are also found within Islam. It was his mission to not only establish the unity of God, but reliance and trust in God, and to promote compassion, kindness and love of the creation of God, particularly the poor, and to also promote the unity between Hindus and Muslims, and in fact, people of all faiths. We find various references in the Janam Sakhis, which are the biographies of Guru Baba Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj, Rahmatullah Alayh, speaking about the Muslim Kalima, which is evidence of his love of the unity of God. For example, in Janam Sakhi Bhai Wala, he has recorded to have said, Kalam padhiyan ae gun hoye gunaon paak, agge kare guna, fir behishto mile talaak. Meaning, by reading the Kalima, these actions became purified from sin. If after reading it one commits sin, then he can no longer enter paradise. So Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj, Rahmatullah Alayh, recognized the importance of the unity of God and always placed his trust in him alone, even when he faced great trials and hardships. Guru Baba Nanak Dev Ji, Rahmatullah Alayh, believed that everything is a creation of God, and human beings were created with the light of God. He states, Avval Allah Noor Upaya Kudrat ke sab bande, ik noor se sab jag ija, kon bhale kon mande. Meaning, God first created light from which he then created the entire universe. So how can there be this distinction that someone should be born good or evil? He also presented a God who is forgiving and merciful and believed in eternal paradise. This is also something which is in line with the teaching of Islam. The Holy Quran speaks of the entire universe, the heavens and the earth being a manifestation of the light of Allah. It is stated in the Holy Quran, Allahu nurus samawati wal ard. Allah is the light of the heavens and the earth. When the Mughal Emperor Babur invaded Ahmedabad and arrested many people there, among them was Guru Baba Nanak Devji Maharaj Rahmatullah Alayh, who was also imprisoned. When Baba recognized the Guru upon seeing him, he freed him, and while apologizing for having caused him pain, he told him to ask for whatever he wanted. And now look at the trust Guru Baba Nanak Devji Maharaj Rahmatullah Alayh had in God. He said that everyone receives sustenance from the one God. Whoever relies on people loses both his faith and the world. There is only one who gives, and the whole world begs him. This was his unwavering trust in his Lord. A personal example of Guru Baba Nanak Devji Maharaj's love of humanity is evident from this incident, which is famously known as Sacha Sota, meaning a true bargain. This was when his father had given him some money for the purpose of trade, which he spent on some poor sadhus who were hungry. He declared that this was a true trade, Sacha Sota. If today world leaders and countries followed this noble example of Guru Baba Nanak Devji Maharaj Rahmatullah Alayh and helped poorer nations instead of only looking at their own interests, then the world would be a much better place to live in. Guru Baba Nanak Devji Maharaj Rahmatullah Alayh was a champion for peace. He opposed fighting and anarchy and sowed the seeds of love, peace and harmony. In Guru Granth Sahib, we find that Guru Baba Nanak Ji Rahmatullah Alayh has firmly spoken out against creating mischief, disorder and fighting. I would now like to present something which is of great interest to all those who consider Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj Rahmatullah Alayh to be a holy saint. I am referring to the Chola Baba Nanak, a memorabilia of Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj Rahmatullah Alayh. The Chola Baba Nanak is a robe which is located in Dera Baba Nanak, which is in the district of Gurdaspur, Punjab. It is kept there with great respect and reverence in a Gurdwara, which was built by the children of Kabli Mal, who was from the progeny of Guru Baba Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj. Chola Baba Nanak is made of poplin and is of a brown color with some red marks. According to the Janam Sakhi Bhai Bala Wali, or as it is more famously known as the Angad Janam Sakhi, it has 30 parts of the Holy Quran written on it, and that it has all the attributes of Allah written on it, which are mentioned in the Holy Quran. This chola is said to have been sent down from the heavens for Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj, and it is said that it was written upon by divine power and was sewn by divine power, and Guru Nanak Ji Rahmatullah Alayh was also dressed in it by divine power, as described in the Janam Sakhi Bhai Bala. At this point, it is appropriate for me to introduce the founder of my community. I belong to the Ahmadiyya Muslim community, and our founder was a man named Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmad alayhi salam, who claimed to be the reformer of this age. Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmad alayhi salam, peace be upon him, was born in a village called Qadian, which is situated near Batala in the district of Gurdaspur. He founded the Ahmadiyya Muslim community in 1889. When Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmad alayhi salam learned of the Chola Sahib and its whereabouts, he sent a delegation to go and investigate for themselves. He instructed them not to rely on what anyone said and to go and see it for themselves. Once they returned, they narrated what happened and presented their findings. They said they met with the progeny of Baba Kabli Malji, who were very receptive and hospitable, and were able to see the Chola Sahib, and they saw the Islamic Kalima, La ilaha illallahu, Muhammadur Rasulullah, meaning there is no God but Allah, Muhammad is the messenger of Allah, written on the garment. However, upon hearing this account, Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Muhammad, peace be upon him, did not content himself with this alone. He decided after making prayers that he would go to see it himself. He made this journey from Qadian on 30th of September 1895 and was accompanied by 10 of his companions and was joined by some from the local area. In his book entitled Sat Bachan, in which he has responded to the allegations leveled by the Hindu Pandit Dhyanand against Guru Baba Nanak Devji Rahmatullah Alayh, and he has exonerated him from these allegations in this book, he has given a detailed account of this visit to Dera Baba Nanak, where the Chola Sahib is kept. In short, it was not easy to get the opportunity to see the Chola Sahib, which was covered with layers of garments which numbered around 300 or more. He and his companions were then given an opportunity to see the entire Chola Sahib after one by one all the garments had been removed. Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmad alayhi salam found that the Chola Sahib was covered with verses from different chapters of the Holy Quran. The Kalima, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, including the opening chapter of the Holy Quran and the attributes of Allah as mentioned in the Holy Quran. The fact that the Chola Sahib had survived for over 400 years was a miracle in itself. And it has been well looked after with great reverence for this long period of time. According to the book Sakhi Chola Sahib, which is a book in the possession of the progeny of Baba Kabli Malji, after the demise of Guru Nanak Devji Maharaj Rahmatullah Alayhi, it was passed on to his successor, Shri Guru Angadji, and who wore it on his head out of reverence for it. And each Guru after him did the same and sought blessings from it. When it reached Shri Guru Arjunji, it was gifted by him to a sincere and loyal companion who requested him for it. Later it came back into the possession of the progeny of Baba Kabli Malji. So what does all this mean? Well, one thing is for sure, that Guru Nanak Devji Maharaj Rahmatullah Alayh had the utmost respect for the religion of Islam, so much so that he wore the Chola Sahib, which was covered with the verses of the Holy Quran, to express these feelings. Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmad, the Imam Mahdi and the Promised Messiah and the founder of the Ahmadi Muslim community, peace be upon him, states, Beshak wo chola apni un tamam paak ayaton ke saath jo us par likhi hui hain Baba Sahib ki ek paak yaadgar hai aur paak hai wo makan jisme wo rakha gaya aur paak hai wo kapda jis par wo ayat likhi gayi hain aur paak tha wo wujood jis jo usko pehne phirta tha aur mubarak wo hain jo us chola sahib ke kalam se barkat dhoondte hain. Meaning, no doubt the chola with all the holy verses written upon it is a holy memorabilia of Guru Nanak Devji Maharaj Rahmatullah Alayh. And holy is the house in which it is kept, and holy is the cloth on which these verses have been written, and holy was the man who walked around wearing it. And blessed and fortunate are those who seek to derive blessings from the verses of the chola. He further states in the form of a poem, Yehi paak chola hai sikhon ka taaj, yehi kabli mal ke ghar mein hai aaj, yehi hai ke nooron se maamoor hai, jo dur isse usse khuda dur hai, yehi janam saakhi mein mazkoor hai, jo angad se is waqt mashhoor hai. Meaning, it is this holy chola, which is the crown of Sikhs. The house of Kabli Mal is where it is located today. It is this which is filled with light. God is distant from him who is distant from this. This is what is written in the Janam Sakhi, which is famously known as Angad at this time. Guru Baba Nanak Ji Rahmatullah Alayh is also known to have traveled to the holy city of Makkah. A reputed Sikh sage by Guru Das Ji writes, Then Baba traveled to Makkah in blue garments, with a walking stick in hand, the book under his arm, a water pitcher and a cloth for prayer. This is recorded in Wara by Gurdas. According to the Janam Sakhis, he stayed there for a period of almost 2 years. This also illustrates the close ties he had with the religion of Islam, as it drove him to visit the holy land of Muslims and to see the holy Kaaba and the resting place of the founder of Islam. Peace and blessings of Allah be upon him. Guru Baba Nanak Ji Rahmatullah Alayh is known to have carried a copy of the Holy Quran, which is referred to in his historical accounts, which he kept under his study, again showing his reverence for the religion of Islam. And the book which he is described to have taken with him to Mecca appears to be this very copy of the Quran, which we refer to as Hamail Sharif, a small copy of the Quran, which became known as Pothi Sahib. The copy of the Quran existed in Guru Har Sahai in the district of Ferozpur till 1931. Khalsa Samachar, a newspaper of repute of Amritsar, reported in this connection, a copy of the Holy Quran is lying in Guru Har Sahai district, Ferozpur, and it is believed that this is the Holy Quran which Guru Nanak Dev Ji carried with him on his journey to Mecca and Medina. Khalsa Samachar, Amritsar, October 8, 1931. A deputation of our community went to Guru Har Sahai and saw that Holy Quran. This delegation included the second successor of our holy founder, Hazrat Mirza Bashiruddin Mahmud Ahmad. May Allah be pleased with him. Sardar G.B. Singh, retired Postmaster General, writes, all the members of the deputation were educated. The Holy Quran was on their fingertips. There could be no mistake in calling it the Holy Quran after seeing the Pathi. Prachin Guru Nanak and the Sikh religion. Another scholar, Bhai Kaliyan Das Ji, writes in this context, Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmad sent some of his adherents of Guru Har Sahai district, Ferozpur, on 6 April 1908. On reaching there, they saw the book in the presence of the custodian, Bishan Singh, and discovered that it was the Holy Quran. Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj Rahmatullah Alayh is known to have travelled to various shrines of Muslim saints and performed chilla, which is to camp in one place in complete solitude and devote oneself to the worship of God and prayers. For example, he stayed in seclusion next to the shrine in Sarsa of Sheikh Abdul Shakur Salmi Sai for 40 days. The room in which he stayed is commonly known as Chilla Baba Nanak. And groups of Sikhs travel from Punjab and Sindh and other areas to visit this place. Similarly, Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj Rahmatullah Alayh also performed a Chilla in Multan at the shrine of Hazrat Shah Shams Tabriz for 40 days, and the room where he stayed is located to the south side of the shrine and is also referred to as Chilla Nanak. The local Muslims and Hindus of the area are united on the fact that Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj came here and stayed for 40 days and performed a chilla. When we look at the Guru Granth Sahib, the chapter recording the verses of Baba Nanak Dev Ji, we find that the teachings are very similar to that of the Holy Quran. I will briefly present a few examples to illustrate this. And the whole purpose of mentioning these similarities with Islam is to show how close religion of Islam is to this holy faith of Sikhism, and how it brings us closer together in a spirit of unity and brotherhood. This hymn of Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj Rahmatullah Alayh, in which he describes God as being the provider of all. Kita akhan akhiye akhan tootna ho, mangan wale kitri data ikoso, jiske jiya pran hai man vasse sukho. Meaning, there is no limit to saying how much more. There are so many beggars, but only one giver, who created the souls and the bodies. If he dwells in one's heart, then he would find peace. So if God were to dwell in our hearts, it would fill our hearts with light and we would be at peace. This is a subject presented also by the Holy Quran. It is stated in the Holy Quran وَمَا مِن دَابَةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا. And there is no creature that moves in the earth, but it is for Allah to provide it with sustenance. So God is providing for everyone. There is no beggar, but God provides for him. So this is also mentioned in the Quran. In another place, Guru Baba Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj states, Ape nere dur, ape munjmian, ape dekhe sune, ape kudrat kare jahan. Meaning he is near, referring to God. He is near and he is far, and he is in the middle. He himself sees and hears, and he created and governs the universe. Speaking of the same attributes of God, the Holy Quran states, Huwal awwalu wal akhiru wal zahiru wal batinu. He is the first and the last, and the manifest and the hidden. وَهُوَ الَّذِي فِي السَّمَاءِ إِلَهٌ وَفِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَهٌ. And he it is who is God in heaven, meaning far, and God on earth, meaning near. Guru Baba Nanak Dev Ji, Rahmatullah Alay, is very beloved to us. He was truly a chosen man of God. In his Shabad, Guru Nanak Dev Ji, Rahmatullah Alay, has praised the holy founder of Islam, Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Ditta Noor Muhammadi, Ditta Nabi Rasool, Nanak Kudrat Dekar Khudi Gai Sabool. Moreover, our love for him is evident from this quotation of the promised Messiah and founder of our community, Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmad, may peace be upon him. Ye wohi mard khuda hai jisne duniyadari ke hazaron pardon ko phaad kar aur be ja rasmon ki bandishon ko tod kar khuda ko ikhtiyar kiya tha. Uske kalam aur uske har ek fikre se maloom hota hai ke bila shubha woh un logon mein se hai jinko khuda apne haath se saaf karta hai aur jinke dilon ko duniya se bezaar karke apni taraf khench leta hai aur jinke seenon mein woh apni mohabbat ki aag rakh deta hai. In conclusion, these various aspects of the life of Guru Baba Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj, which I have presented, show the common teaching of both Islam and Sikhism and the strong relationship both have enjoyed and what unites us. As I mentioned previously, Islam Ahmadiyyat originated from a village in India called Qadian. Besides the Ahmadiyya community living in Qadian, there is a large Sikh community both living there peacefully in a spirit of brotherhood and respect for one another. In fact, every year in December, when Ahmadis flock to Qadian from around the world to attend the annual convention, the Sikh community is very welcoming to all of the guests coming to attend the spiritual gathering. I have been informed my time is up, but I would just like to finish on this last point. In October 2017, I had the good fortune of visiting India. During my time there, I not only had the opportunity to visit Qadian, our headquarters, but I also had the privilege to visit the Golden Temple in Amritsar. I was very much impressed by how we were warmly welcomed, treated with the utmost respect, and given a fast-track tour of the temple. It is an experience that I will never forget. I saw for myself that there were many practices we also share in common. For example, the covering of the head, as I see all of you doing today, washing one's feet before entering the house of God for worship, the langar, etc. These are all things I found common. This experience has left a lasting impression on me. Once again, I thank you all for this great opportunity that you have invited me on the occasion of the 550th birth anniversary of Guru Nanak Dev Ji Maharaj, Rahmatullah Alayhi. So I truly, from the bottom of my heart, I thank you and for inviting the members of my community. Wahe Guru Ji Ki Khalsa, Wahe Guru Ji Ki Fateh. Thank you.